वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम उजाला देवंगन, योर मैथ्स टीचर। टुडे वी विल लर्न मेकिंग ऑफ परफेक्ट स्क्वायर फ्रॉम गिवन नंबर एंड सम कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ परफेक्ट स्क्वायर। सो स्टार्ट, फर्स्ट वी लर्न मेकिंग द परफेक्ट स्क्वायर फ्रॉम नंबर। 8 is not a perfect square. If we factorize 8, we get 2 4 is 8, 2 2 is 4, 2 1 is 2. 8 is equal to 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2. This 2 form pair and this 2 is not forming any pair. Therefore, 8 is not a perfect square. If we multiply 2 by the number, we get 1, 2 extra, and then number change into perfect square. So, if we multiply 2 in 8, we get perfect square. If we dividing 2 by 8, 2 and 2 cancel, and remaining multiples factor are in pair, so number is also in perfect square. If we divide 2 by 8, we get 4, that means 2 into 2, and the number turn into perfect square. That means we to multiply the number or divide the number, we get change any number to perfect square. Now, for more understanding making the perfect square, we take a question from your textbook. Question number 1 of practice exercise 2. The question is, find out the smallest number which when multiplied by 200 so that the product becomes a perfect square. Find out the smallest number which when multiplied by 200 so that the product becomes a perfect square. Solution of question 1 of exercise 2. We factorize given number 200. Unit digit of 200 is 0, so it is divisible by 2. 2 1 is 2, 2 0 is 0, 2 0 is 0. 100 is also divisible by 2, so we divide 100 by 2. 2 5 is 10, 2 0 is 0. Again divisible by 2, 2 2 is 4, 1 0 10, and 2 5 is 10. Now 25 is not divisible by 2 because its unit digit is 5. It is also not divisible by 3. Why? Because sum of these two number is 7. 2 plus 5 is 7. And 7 is not divisible by 3. So 25 is also not divisible by 3. Next prime number is 5. And 25 is divisible by 5. 5 5 is 21. 5 1 is 100. Is equal to 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 5. Making pair, 2 into 2 first pair and 5 into 5 second pair. Since 2 does not form any pair, so if we multiply 200 by 2, the product becomes a perfect square. Hence, the required list number is 2. We take another question of our textbook, that is question number 3. Find out the smallest number which, when divided by 2352, make a quotient a perfect square. It is divisible by 2 because its last digit is 2. 2 ones are 2, 2 ones are 2, remaining 1, 1 5 15, 2 7s are 14. Remaining 1, 1 2 12 and 2 6 are 12. Now it is divisible by 2. 2 5s are 10, 1 remain, 1 7 17, 2 8s are 16, 1 6 16, 2 8s are 16. Again divisible by 2. 2 2s are 4, 1 8 18, 2 9s are 18 and 2 4s are 8. Divisible by 2. 2 1s are 2, 2 4s are 8, 1 4, 14, 2 7s are 14. Now 147 is not divisible by 2. So we take next prime number 3. Sum of these digits 1 plus 4 plus 7 is 12 and 12 is divisible by 3. So 147 is also divisible by 3. Now divide 147 by 3. 3 4s are 12, remaining number is 2 and next number 7, 2 7 27, 3 9s are 27. Now 49 is not divisible by 3 because sum is 13 and 13 is not divisible by 3. Next prime number 5, 49 is also not divisible by 5 because its last digit is not 0 or 9. Next prime number is 7. And 49 is divisible by 7. 7 7s are 49. 2352 is equal to 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 7 and multiplied by 7. Form pair. We get only 3. Cannot form pair. Since 3 does not form pair, so if we divide 2352 by 3, we get quotient is a perfect square. Hence, the required list number is 3. Now we form a table to learn the characteristics or property of perfect square. Number perfect square 1, square of 1 is 1, 2, square of 2 is 4,
3, 9, 4, 16, 5, 25, 22, 484.
Now see carefully, square of odd numbers and square of even numbers. Square of odd numbers. Square of 1 is 1, that means odd number. Square of odd number 3 is 9, it is also odd number. Square of 5 is 25, it is also odd number. Square of 7, 49. If you see carefully, we get square of any odd number is always a odd number. Square of any odd number is always an odd number. And square of even number. Square of 2 is 4. Square of 6 is 36 is also a even number. Square of 8 is 64, even number. Square of 10, 100 is also even number. That means square of an odd number is always odd number, or square of any even number is always even number. This is the first property. Square of any odd number is always odd number, and square of any even number is always even number. Now see carefully, its unit place of perfect square. Unit place of perfect square, 1, 4, 9, 6, 5, 6, 9, 4, 1, 0. 1, 11 is also, unit place is 1. 1, if 2, 4, 3, 9, 169, 4, 16, 6, 5, 5, 5. If we take 23, we get 529. Ones place, 3, 9, 13, 3, 9, 23, 3, 9, 4, 16, 6, 14, 4, 196, 6, 24, 576, 6. If we see carefully, we can find 2, 3, 7 and 8. 2, 3, 7, 8 are not finding in ones place of perfect square. That means second property of perfect square is those numbers whose unit place have numbers like 2, 3, 7, 8 cannot be a perfect square. That means by seeing at a glance, we can say that this is a perfect square or not if their unit place is 2, 3, 7, 8. If unit place of any number is 2, 3, 7, 8, then that is not a perfect square. If unit place is 0, 1, 4, 5, 6, 9, then may or may not be perfect square. May and may not be. That means 25. Unit place is 5. It is a perfect square. 5 is 25. But 15, unit place is 5. But 15 is not a perfect square. That means if we find unit place is 0, 1, 4, 5, 6 and 9, then may or may not be perfect square. But if you find unit place is 2, 3, 7, 8, then confirmedly say the number is not a perfect square. For example, if given number is 341, if given number is 342, and your question is 342 is a perfect square. So without factorization we can say that 342 is not a perfect square, because ending last digit is 2, and if last digit is 2 then it is not a perfect square. So property, a perfect square cannot be ending with 2 3 7 8. A perfect square cannot be ending with 2 3 7 8. Now we take another property, zeros. We get in perfect square 2 0. 400 is the perfect square of 20. If we multiply 300 by 300, we get, that means a perfect square ending with even zeros may or may not be perfect square. If any number ending with odd zeros, then confirmly we can say that it is not a perfect square. For example, 90. This 90 has only one zero, therefore we can say that 90 is not a perfect square because it's ending with odd zero. So there are four characteristics. Number one, perfect square of odd number is always odd number. Perfect square of an even number is always even number. A perfect square cannot be ending with 2, 3, 7, 8. A perfect square cannot be ending with odd zeros. Question number 2 of exercise 1.1. Question is, give reasons why the given numbers are not perfect square. First number is 1200. Say this 12,000 is not a perfect square. Why? We can say that because 12,000 ending with odd zeros, there are 3 zeros. Because 12,000 ending with odd zeros, therefore 12,000 is not a perfect square. Second number is 1227, and question is, why 1227 is not a perfect square? This 1227 is not a perfect square because it's ending with 7. We can learn a property, a number ending with 2, 3, 7, 8 is not a perfect square. So 1227 is not a perfect square because its unit digit is 7. 790 is not a perfect square because it's ending with odd zero, single zero. Therefore, it is not a perfect square. 1482. It is also not a perfect square because its unit digit is 2. I hope all of you understand. Thank you. Stay home and stay safe.